बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम। हाउ आर यू माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स? आई एम टॉकिंग फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ ऑनर्स फोर्थ ईयर, दैट इज फाइनल ईयर, एज 4। टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस कोर्स टाइटल 19th सेंचुरी नोबेल। यू हैव अ गुड सिलेबस ऑफ 19th सेंचुरी नोबेल। दीज आर प्राइड एंड प्रेजुडाइज, अ टेल ऑफ टू सिटीज, जेन आयर, टेज ऑफ द डी आरवर वेल्स। टुडे I would like to discuss the major themes of Pride and Prejudice written by Jane Austen. So dear students, please follow me. I am talking for the students of honors fourth year. So major theme of Pride and Prejudice, I am talking on this very topic. First of all, main theme, pride. As Mary says in chapter 5, human nature is particularly prone to pride. Throughout Pride and Prejudice, pride prevents the characters from seeing the truth of a situation. Most notably, it is one of the two primary barriers in the way of a union between Elizabeth and Darcy. Darcy's pride in his social position leads him to scorn anyone outside of his own social circle. Meanwhile, Elizabeth's pride in her powers of discernment cloud her judgment. These two find happiness by helping each other overcome his her pride. Outside of Elizabeth and Darcy, however, Austen seems pessimistic about the human ability to conquer this character flaw. A slew of secondary characters like Mrs. Bennet, Lady Catherine, Mr. Collins, and Caroline Bingley remained deluded by personal pride throughout the novel. Dear students, now let me talk about another major theme, prejudice. Critic Walton Leeds comments, "In Pride and Prejudice, one cannot equate Darcy with pride or Elizabeth with prejudice. Darcy's pride of place is founded on social prejudice, while Elizabeth's initial prejudice against him is rooted in pride of her own quick perceptions. Ultimately, both characters' egos drive them towards personal prejudice. Darcy has been taught to scorn anyone outside his own social circle and must overcome his prejudice in order to endear himself to Elizabeth. Similarly, Elizabeth's excessive pride in her discernment leads to her right Darcy off too quickly. Ultimately, they find happiness by recognizing the barriers that prejudice creates. Another important theme is family. So dear students, follow me. Austen portrays the family unit as primarily responsible for the intellectual and moral education of children. Throughout the novel, the younger characters either benefit from or suffer from their family values. Mr. and Mrs. Bennet's failure to provide their daughters with a proper education leads to Lydia's utter foolishness and immorality. Elizabeth and Jane manage to develop virtue and discernment in spite of their parents' negligence. though it is notable that they have other role models like the gardeners. Darcy shares his father's aristocratic nature and tendency towards generosity, while Lady Catherine's formidable parenting style has rendered her daughter too frightened to speak. So, dear students, now another important theme that is on women. Austen is certainly critical of gender injustice present in 19th century English society, particularly as perpetuated by the institution of marriage. In Pride and Prejudice, many women, such as Caroline, Charlotte, must marry solely for the sake of financial security. However, in her portrait of Elizabeth, Austen shows that women are just as intelligent and capable as their male counterparts. Jane Austen herself went against convention by remaining single and earning a living through her novels. In her personal letters, Austen advised friends only to marry for love. In the novel, Elizabeth's happy ending reveals Austen's beliefs that women has the right to remain independent until she meets the right man, if she meets him. On the other hand, most contemporary readers will find the long-born entailment to be unjust, and yet the heroines Jane and Elizabeth refrain from speaking out against it. Instead, the only two characters who openly criticize the entailment, Mrs. Bennet and Lady Catherine, are ridiculous caricatures. Furthermore, the fact that Elizabeth seems to share her father's distrust, frivolous women, suggest Austen's uneasy relationship with her own gender. So, dear students, please follow me. Now, I am going to discuss another important theme, that is class. Class issues are everywhere in Pride and Prejudice. While the novel never posits an egalitarian ideology nor supports the leveling of all social classes, it does criticize an overemphasis on class, especially in terms of judging a person's character. Ultimately, the novel accepts Elizabeth's view that the trappings of wealth are not a virtue in and of themselves. Darcy's initial pride is based on his extreme class consciousness, but he eventually comes to accept Elizabeth's perspective, most notably evidenced through his admiration of the gardeners. Likewise, he joins Elizabeth in rejecting the upper class characters who are idle, mean-spirited, closed-minded, like Lady Catherine and Bingley's sisters. Austen clearly finds rigid class boundaries to be occasionally absurd. Mr. Collins' comic formality and obsequious relationship with Lady Catherine form a setter of class consciousness and social formalities. In the end, novel's verdict on class differences is moderate. Austin seems to accept the existence of class hierarchy, but she also criticizes the way it can poison society. Critic Samuel Kleiger notes, if the conclusion of the novel makes it clear that Elizabeth accepts class relationship as valid, it becomes equally clear that Darcy, through Elizabeth's genius for treating all people with respect for their natural dignity, is reminded that institutions are not an end in themselves, but are intended to serve the end of human happiness. So, dear students, another important theme is individual versus society. In Pride and Prejudice, Austen portrays a world in which society is actively involved in the private lives of individuals. Characters open face questions about their responsibility to the world around them. A prime example of Darcy's guilt for not having publicly shamed Wickham before he was able to elope with Lydia. After all, Lydia's sin threatens to besmirch not only her family but the community at large, and yet Austen seems quite well aware of how easily public opinion can sense, as evidenced by the town's easily shifting opinions on Wickham. Elizabeth, meanwhile, is proudly independent and individualistic. She possesses the ability to transcend her limitations. The negligence of her parents, the frivolity of Meryton, the pragmatic nature of Charlotte, because she is confident enough to go after what she wants. However, her individualistic nature misleads her as she works through her feelings for Darcy, but thankfully Mrs. Gardiner is there to guide her towards him. Ultimately, Austen is critical of the power public opinion has on individual action, but she also believes that society has a crucial role in promoting virtue and therefore endearing individual happiness. According to critic Richard Simpson, Austen portrays through consciousness that man is a social being and that apart from society, there is not even the individual. So, dear students, this is the last theme of the novel Pride and Prejudice, that is, I am talking on Virtue. Austen's novels unite Aristotelian and Christian conceptions of Virtue. She sees human life as purposeful and believes that human beings must guide their appetites and desires through their use of reason. For instance, Elizabeth almost loses her chance at happiness because her vanity overcomes her pragmatism. Lydia's lack of virtue is linked with her inability to control her passion and desire. Most of these examples emphasize the importance of self-awareness. without knowing oneself, it is difficult to develop virtue. Darcy and Elizabeth, two of the only characters who actually change in the novel, can only see past their pride and prejudice with each other's help. In the end, Austen links happiness to virtue and virtue of self-awareness. So, dear students, this is all from today. The major themes of Pride and Prejudice written by Jane Austen, course title 19th Century Novel. So, dear students, I think all of you have understood the major themes of Pride and Prejudice. Actually, in different point of views, in different critics, different writers, different high class people have discussed many themes of different novels, especially in Pride and Prejudice, written by Jane Austen. So, you have been benefited by my lecture, undoubtedly, if you have concentration to my lecture and my speech. So, my suggestion is to you that you never go for memorization. Actually, literature cannot be learned with memorization. So, try to understand the literature, then you can enjoy literature and can be successful in your real life situation. So, this is all from today. Thank you. Bye. Assalamu alaikum. Stay at home. Stay safe. No more today. Thank you.